Tinaiti nga malam kakabsat, nakatado nga min, digiti lessons, marami akong mga lessons na gustong ma-share sa inyo. Hindi ko alam kung saan ang pipiliin ko, pero palagay ko makakatulong sa inyo itong lesson na aking isi-share na ang pamagat is how to deal with stress. Oo, kitantay man tiro pa takaabay tayo kakabsat, no, stressed. Amen. Kumusta kayo nga data Zoom? Mukhang stress yata yung iba sa inyo. Okay, gusto kong magbahagi sa inyo ng mga biblical points and biblical truths on how we can deal with stress. The reality of life is that we face pressures from day to day. Wala pong araw na hindi tayo mapipressure. Ngunit, subalit, sabi ng Biblia sa 1 Corinto chapter 15 verse number 58, we can find in this passage in 57 it says, "But thanks be to God which giveth us the victory." Praise God. We don't need to be defeated. We don't need to be depressed. We don't need to be to accept failure or accept negative things in our mind, because the Bible says God gives victory, and that victory is through our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, bakit through our Lord Jesus Christ? Hindi po, wala po kayong pwedeng i-substitute sa Panginoon. You cannot substitute Christ with money. You cannot substitute Christ with a good number of friends. You cannot substitute Christ with your education. Victory doesn't come from friends. It doesn't come from your education. It doesn't come from material things. Victory comes through Jesus Christ. Even the Apostle Paul said in Philippians chapter 4, "I can do all things through Christ which strengtheneth me." Amen? Now, not only that, the truth is God gives us victory, but in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse number 16, it says, "For which cause we faint not." This is another Bible truth. "But though our outward men perish," okay? Kita nyo man takaabay yun, no? Umubing, uno lumaklakay, bumakbakit. Kita man, ni Brother Erwin, katkaslahan na lumaklakay eh. Amen? Nang nangruna, ngahan na bumakbakit. Amen? Delikado, Brother Erwin, no, bumakbakit ka. Okay lang di lumaklakay, huwag lang na bumakbakit. Amen, Brother Erwin? Okay? Pero ang sabi ng Biblia, that even though the outward men perish, that's a reality. Okay? Hindi talaga natin ma-prevent na tayo po ay tumatanda. May mga tao na parang hindi tumatanda, no? Oo. Pero the outward men perish, but the Bible says the inward man is renewed day by day. So may dalawa pala na aspect na pinapakita ng Panginoon sa atin. Yung isa is out of our control, but the other one is within our control. Yung out of control is the deterioration of the outward man, but what is within our control is the renewing of the inward man day by day. So if you're going to really focus on something, do not just focus on the outward man. Pinaggagastusan niya ng maraming cosmetics ngayon, di ba? Cosmetology, maraming mga derma. You know, we spend so much money on the outward man, but we forget that we cannot control it. You know, the only thing that matters now is the inward man, which is being renewed day by day. Ang tanong eh, paano ba? Ano tong renewing of the inward man day by day, Pastor? Dito sa Isaiah chapter 40, verse number 30 and 31, tignan nyo ang sinasabi ng Biblia dito. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 30 and 31. It says, "Even the youth shall faint." Fainting is a result of not being able to cope up. Hindi na kaya. So magfe-faint ka na talaga. Kung kaya pa naman, hindi ka naman magfe-faint eh. Diba? And you know, there are many aspects of life where we find it hard to cope up any longer. Sometimes we find it difficult to cope up with relationship. Sometimes we find it difficult to cope up with our job demands or career demands. Sometimes we find it difficult to cope up with family needs. It's difficult to cope up even with ministry responsibilities. Di ba? Hirap na tayo. And because we cannot cope up with it anymore, we faint. And it's a reality. So, hindi po masama na minsan ating talagang aminin na hindi ko na kaya. Talaga, mga kapatid, huwag mong sabihin na kaya mo kung hindi mo na talaga kaya. So, just be honest. Just be realistic, you know, to admit na hindi mo na kaya. Kasi sabi ng Bible, even the youth shall faint and be weary. Hindi masama na sometimes tanggapin mo na I'm tired. Di ba? Kagabi nga pambihira. Biro mo yung buong araw na ministering ko. Nag-Sunday school lesson ako. Hindi po basta-basta yung pagturo ko ng Sunday school. Dahil, you know, I really wanted to give the best I can to explain that Sunday school lesson. Then I preached, di ba? After I preached, nag-lunch kami, nagpahinga lang ng konti, kaya the power nap, nag-proceed kami sa Dingras. On-preach na naman ako doon, mga kapatid. Pagkatapos sa Dingras, timpun namin yung lote, nag-dinner kami, yun, busog. Na-replenish yung katawan, pero yung weariness, alam mo yung pagod ka, hindi mo kayang i-replenish yun eh. Tulog lang talaga yun, di ba? But from there, pumunta kami sa necrological service. Oh, 8:30 na nag-start dahil bumiyahe pa kami, 6:30 mula Dingras. Oh, nagbihis ako. Tapos punta na kami sa necrological, preach ako. Sabi ko doon sa necrological, 8:30 ng gabi, sabi ko, I'm tired. Hindi po masama na talagang admit natin na we are tired, because that's reality. Sabi ng Bible, the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. Diba? Pero ito naman, diba? Ang sabi ng 31, may gamot eh. Diba? Merong way on how we can deal with our stress, with the point na we hardly can cope up with it any longer. Sabi ng 31, but they that wait upon the Lord. Yun pala yung dapat mong gawin. Meron ka palang dapat gawin na hindi natin ginagawa lagi, na minsan nakakaligtaan natin gawin. Sabi, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. The word renew is to replace what is gone and put the new strength. Renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings. So an eagle can fly again. A runner can go, continue with his race. And those who walk will not faint. So, ang ating tanong ngayong umaga is, how do we go through this renewing? Paano ba tong bagay na to, Pastor? Kaya nais ko pong ibigay sa inyo ang isang outline na ginawa ko siyang acrostic. The word is REST. R-E-S-T. Gusto nyo bang magkaroon ng quality na rest? Sometimes it is not the how long you sleep eh. Diba? It is the quality of your sleep. Diba? Meron tayong tinatawag na power nap during lunch break. Uray 10 minutes lang, kahit 10 minutes lang yung power nap mo na yun. Pero pag talagang tinawag na power nap, mga kapatid, wow, you feel so rested. Matulog ka nga naman ng 7 hours, na busog. Pagising mo ng umaga, mga kapatid, pagod na pagod ang pakiramdam mo. Wala kang quality rest. So, hindi natin pag-uusapan ngayon yung physical rest. Ang pag-uusapan natin, yung tungkol sa inner man na rest. So, ang spelling ng rest, mga kapatid, is R-E-S-T. Okay? R-E-S-T. Now, the Word of God tells us na ang susi, mga kapatid, nung how to deal with stress, we start with letter R. Letter R stands for when you are stressed, refocus your mind on Christ. When you are overwhelmed with negative things, when you are overwhelmed by fear, when you are overwhelmed by problems, troubles, but when you are in that situation, para kang nasa isang alam mo yung ano ba yung tubig na umiikot na ganyan, gi-spin, may tawag doon eh. When that water in a body of water like river nag-i-spin yan, hinihigop ka. Ganun minsan mga kapatid, when you are overwhelmed by problem and trouble, by fears of the future, parang hinihigop tayo pababa. Gusto nating stay afloat, gusto nating we can continue to move up, pero talagang, you know, we are being dragged down, going down, hinihigop tayo pababa. And you know, the only way that we can renew the inner man is by refocusing our mind on Christ. You know, you come to the Lord in prayer. Tama yung sinasabi ni Preacher Glenn kanina, pag ikaw ay nagkaroon na, naging aware ka na, teka, medyo pababa na ako, palamig na ako, di ba? I am being ruled by my fears. I am making decisions that are being driven by my fears. Parang yung mga Israelites, you know, when they were afraid, sabi nga nila that the land is full of giants, they are consuming man. Parang they will just swallow us alive. Grabe how they magnified their problem, no? And their fear hindered them from entering the promised land. So, pag nandun na tayo sa mga bagay na ganyan, mga kapatid, kailangan nating ma-refocus ang ating mind sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo. When we refocus our mind on the Lord, now, there are some truths, there are some important things that you need to focus in your mind. Una, when you refocus your mind on Christ, dapat maunawaan mo that the Lord is sovereign. You know, no matter how great your problem is, God is still in control. As sabi ng Matthew chapter 28 verse number 18, all power is given unto me. Can you imagine that? The word power means control. When God is sovereign, that means He is in control. Now, the reason being for being stressed is we try to control, we would like things to be controlled. Kaya lang, it's beyond our control. So, we become stressed with that. Iniisip natin, di tayo makatulog, napuproblemahan tayo, at iniisip natin, papaano na pag ganito, ano kayang gagawin? Masosolve ba ito? You know, it's a big problem. Of course, there is a point when you really need to think, assess the situation. Talagang, di ba, mag-iisip ka, paano ito? Ano yung pros and cons, ins and outs? How can I solve this? But even then, you can run out of solution. Di ba? You can still run out from the things that you can do it within your ability. Kaya pag nandun ka sa bagay na yon, panghihinaan ka talaga ng loob. Hihigupin ka pababa. But when you refocus your mind on Christ, you know, it helps you become strong when you realize that God is in control. Amen? Pag sinabing God is in control, no one is greater than Him. When Jesus said, all power is given unto me. Now, ang tanong ko sa inyo, Si President Biden is a powerful man. But are you Americans, do you feel secured having Biden as your president? Diba? I mean, the person in the White House is supposed to be the most powerful man, that when America goes down, the world goes down, ika nga. Eh, the person in the White House is supposed to be the most powerful man, na being an American, you should feel secured, you should feel confident, you know, that the man in the White House, no matter what happens in the world, being an American, hindi ako matatakot sapagkat ang nasa White House, makapangyarihan. Ang punto ko ay ito, Biden is a powerful man, but he is not all-powerful. Diba? Oh, kaya nga, bilang isang Kristiyano, you do not depend on man. You do not depend on whoever is in the White House. You do not depend. Sabi niya nga, vain is the confidence of men. So when you put your confidence of men, you are just putting yourself into a stressful state of life. Ilalagay mo ang sarili mo na may stress ka lang, kapatid. So do not put your confidence in man. Put your confidence in God. So when you're in a situation na talagang there are things beyond your control, you refocus your mind on Christ. That means that you begin to acknowledge God's sovereignty. God's sovereignty also is in Romans chapter 8 verse 28. Sabi doon, and we know that all things work together for good. In other words, God makes sure that ultimately, lahat ng mga dumarating sa buhay natin bilang kanyang mga anak is for good and for His glory and honor. And that will give you calmness of heart. Hindi ka lang magiging kalmado, magiging thankful ka pa. Biruin mo yung problem that used to make you complain, now the problem that makes you thankful. Diba? Biruin mo yung shifting ng ganong klaseng pag-iisip. So, I do not know what you are going through right now. I mean, I can give you some world facts of what's going on in the world right now, and it can make you afraid. Kung may mga savings kayo sa banko, may mga investments kayo sa stock market, kung ano-ano yung mga bagay-bagay na yan. But if you take it, not from a world perspective, but even from life, like, I have this sickness, may sakit ako, problema ko dito. The thing you need to do is to focus your mind on Jesus. So ano yung makita natin kay Kristo? He is sovereign. He's in control. The second thing that you need to realize about Jesus is not only He is sovereign, but He is our shepherd. A shepherd. You know, in John chapter 10, verse number 11, John chapter 10, verse number 11, it says, I am the good shepherd. Wow. What kind of shepherd is Jesus? Good, not an evil shepherd. Verse 12, but he that is an hireling. A hireling is another kind of shepherd, but not the shepherd. He was just hired, he was just paid to do the job of the shepherd, but he is not a shepherd. The hireling and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, dahil hireling siya, hindi sa kanya yung tupa, sees the wolf coming. Can you imagine? The devourer is coming. And what does he do? He leaveth the sheep. Natakot siya doon sa wolf, iniwan niya. And fleeth. And the wolf catcheth them and scattereth the sheep. Praise God. Jesus is not a hireling. He is our shepherd. In fact, He is willing to give His life for the sheep. So there's something you need to understand with Jesus na talagang pag nandun ka sa alanganin, talagang pilitin mong dapat magtiwala sa Kanya ng Panginoon. You even gave your life to save me from hell. You will not leave me and forsake me now. You could save me from hellfire. Now I am in this situation. You will definitely not leave me now. You will definitely not forsake me now. You know, many of the things that's happening in the world today, I find that more people, the more money they have, the more things they can buy, the more stuff they have, the more lonely they are. That's the big problem I see in the world right now. Ang daming pera, ang daming barkada, ang daming mga bagay nasa Amerika. But if you look at it, they are so lonely. Diba? Damagamanta ka abay mo, are you not lonely? Mr. Lonely? Diba? There are so many lonely persons in this world right now. You know? And praise God, mga kapatid, that we have Jesus as our shepherd. You know? Oh, kaya makita ninyo na the way when we look at the Lord Jesus Christ, yung refocusing your mind on Christ, ano yung number one? He is sovereign. He's in control. Okay? Now, number two, He is our shepherd. By being shepherd, He will not leave us. He will not forsake us. He will guide us. Number three, He is our source. He is our source. In 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse number 9, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, it says, "And He said unto me, My grace is sufficient for thee." Now, remember, diba, ano yung problem ni Apostle Paul dito? Meron siyang thorn in the flesh. That thorn stressed him out. Okay? To the point that he came to God and asked God and said, "Lord, remove this from me. Take this away." So, he was stressed out, you know? But God came with a different answer. He said, "No, I will not remove that." Although hindi niya sinabi yon, but it is given if you read between the lines na para sinasabi ng Panginoon, no, I will not take that away from you. Paano yan, Lord? May stress ako nito araw-araw. Sabi ng Panginoon, "I'll give you grace. My grace is sufficient for thee because my strength is made perfect in weakness." So God is saying, "I want you to feel weak. I want you to feel stressed, weary, fainting, and tired, because it is only through that situation that I can make my strength manifest." So Paul said, "Okay, what used to make me complain, I will now thank God for it. Most gladly." Can you imagine that? "What used to depress me, I am glad now. What used to discourage me, it's now a blessing to me. What gave me reason to complain, to murmur, what gave me reason to be weak, what gave me reason to be discouraged, na yung pupunta ako sa church, na parang lupay-pay ako dahil sa mga bagay na ito, ay hindi na. Hindi na," sabi niya, "most gladly therefore will I rather glory." So he was looking at the same problem from a different perspective now. Kaya pag talagang nag-refocus ka sa Panginoon, you will still be looking at the same situation, the same problem, the same trouble, but now you're looking at it from a different perspective. That's what we need. Naunawaan po ninyo? Sabi niya, "Most gladly therefore will I rather glory in my infirmities." Yung pa rin yun, ha? "That the power of Christ may rest upon me." So ang point dito, mga kapatid, is when you refocus your mind on Christ, una, you trust in Him as the sovereign, the in control of everything. Number two, you trust in Him as your shepherd. Ano man ang pinagdadaanan mo, hindi ka iiwan ng Panginoon. Kasama mo siya sa problemang yan, sa apoy na yan ng buhay mo, at igaguide ka niya dahil siya ay shepherd. At pangatlo, siyang panggagalingan ng kalakasan mo. Kaya mga kapatid, nakakatuwa na makita mo ang isang Kristiyano, aware ka na may problema, aware ka na marami siyang pinagdadaanan, pero hindi nawawalan ng sigasig. Tanungin mo kayong katabi mo, masigasig ka pa ba? Are you still zealous? Or are you zealous? Amen? Are you zealous? We should not lose that enthusiasm and zeal. Amen? Alam mo, pag hindi ka marunong na talagang, if you do not, listen, pag hindi nyo kukunin itong sinasabi ko sa inyo, mga kapatid, this can cause backsliding. Maraming causes ang pagbabackslide ng Kristiyano, tandaan nyo yan. Isa sa mga reason na mag-cause ng backsliding ng Kristiyano, yung wrong choices. Pangalawa, yung discouragement. Hindi niya nakayanan ang problema. Hindi niya nakayanan, kaya naupa yun, na-discourage yun, hindi na nagpatuloy, pati paglilingkod sa Panginoon na damay, pag-church damay. Kaya mga kapatid, talagang ina-addressan ko sa inyo na itong stress na bagay na ito, dapat bilang Kristiyano, alam natin paano natin i-deal ang stress. By refocusing our mind on Christ, looking at Him as the sovereign one, looking at Him as the shepherd, He will not leave us, He cares for us, and number three, as our source. Amen po ba? Okay? Number four, not only sovereign, shepherd, and source, but when you refocus your mind on Christ, you need to look at Him as your standard. as your standard. The word standard means someone to follow. Siya yung dapat mong tularan, gayahin. Okay? In Hebrews chapter number 12, verses number 2 and 3, it says in verse number 2, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. So, ti apo di kita, mga di problema. Who for the joy that was set before him, look ha, there was a joy that was waiting for him. Ito siya, ito yung pagdadaanan niyang cross. After that, ito yung joy. So he had to cross the cross to experience the joy that was set before him. So sabi ng Bible, who for the joy that was set before him, despising the shame. You know the word despise? Parang, wala yan. Oh, di ba? It's to look at something big as little. That's the word despise. Pag sinabing, dinidespise niya ako. Ibig sabihin, minamaliit ka. Biruin mo, yung pong pagdaanan mo ng kahihiyan, maliit na bagay yun sa'yo. Come on, think about it. Di ba? Sino sa inyong pinahiyanan ng boss? Pinahiyanan ng tao? I mean, pag dumaan ka dyan, pwede kang mapundi eh. Mapundi ka sa buhay, hindi lang mapundi sa trabaho. Mapundi ka sa buhay, ayaw mo nang magtrabaho, ayaw mo nang mag-ipag-usap sa tao, ayaw mo nang lumabas. Yung simpleng bagay, yung bagay na yan, sinimplify ng Panginoon. Sabi niya, despising the shame. Late lang yan. Biruin mo yun, yung something na laki-laki, overwhelmed ka. Sabi na, late lang yan. Naalala ko nung ano eh, naalala ko nung I was a pastor in Pasokin. I was very young. I was aggressive. I had the Bible college education. But I didn't have that enough strength to face the problem of life. May problema kami noon. May isang miyembro, problem namin. So dahil hindi ko kaya, tinawag ko si Pastor John. Nag-request ako. O yan na, di hinarap kami mga kapatid. Ako talagang problemado. Isip ko na lahat, yung mga pros and cons nito. Hindi ako makatulog ng ilang gabi. Bas pagpahira, paano kaya to? Si Pastor John nandun lang, nakaupo. Tapos nagaganyan siya. Oh. Parang relax na relax lang siya. Oh, simple lang yan. Sabi niya, ikaw, kung hindi ka na makapag-ano kay Pastor Proby, malis ka na rito. Oh, huwag ka nang mag-church dito. So, okay. Oh, tapos na. Ganun lang si Pastor John. Tingin ako sa kanya. Tapos, maya-maya, di tinanong ko siya. Sabi ko sa kanya, pa, sabi ko, bakit parang ang simple sa'yo yung problema? Sa akin, komplikado. Sa'yo, simple. Among di ko nana, kunana, hindi kita nga banag, na-immunak ti problema, kunana. Amoy, di word nga na-immune. Ibig sabihin, marami na siyang pinagdaanan na nakita niya na ang Panginoon na kumilos sa mga problem niya. He saw the Lord deliver him. He saw the Lord provided for him. He saw the Lord saved him from all of those trouble. Sabi niya, if the Lord saved me from all of this trouble, can he not save me now? Ngayon pa ako hindi magtitiwala sa kanya sa problemang to. Kaya you have to remind each other, kayong mga couples, remind each other pag nadi-discourage yung partner mo. Sabi mo sa kanya, ngayon pa, ang dami ng mga ginawa ng Panginoong mabuti sa atin. Ngayon ka pa madi-discourage. Tutuusin nga, mas maliit yung problema mo ngayon eh. Mas matindi yung mga problem na pinagdaanan natin. Ngayon ka pa madi-discourage. Ngayon ka pa mag-quit. O yun, yung sabi ni Pastor John. Na-immune ako. So, ibig sabihin, you know, nakita niya ng Panginoon eh. O bumalik tayo sa ating pinag-uusapan ha. Sabi ng Panginoon, despising the shame. Ano yung una? Endure the cross. O, inanusan na kakabsat. Hello? Despising the shame. And he sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Verse 3. For consider him. Yun yung sinasabi ko. Consider him. That's the time when you have to refocus your mind on Christ. That's what we lack. Because we have been programmed by the society to always be on the go. We have never been programmed by society to, hey, okay, take time, a little moment, take time to pray. Wala na yun eh. I don't even know if you are praying, if you're having your daily quiet time, your devotion, if you're spending more time with God. In fact, the secret to a strong public life is your private time with God. It's the moment of prayer that makes a big difference in your life, my friend. Not the times that you were busy, not the times that you were go, 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 do, 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 do. No, it's the time when you were praying a lot. Kaya mga kapatid, kayo, I advise you, pag nagda-drive, kayo drive and pray. Ako nga, I used to drive to Manila when we go attend conference, and I like to drive. No, during those days, ngayon, ayoko nang mag-drive eh, kasi medyo, humihina na rin tayo, mga kapatid. Medyo inaantok na tayo pag nagda-drive. Kaya kung may murang flight dyan, sige, eroplano na lang tayo. But I used to drive. And you know, I am a kind of passenger. I don't want to be a passenger. I want to be the driver. Totoo yan, lalo pag long drive. Ayoko yung ako nakasakay. Gusto ko yung ako nagda-drive. Pero kung hindi ko na kaya talagang yung nagbiyahe nga kami sa Isabela, I let Preacher Glenn drive. Di ba? Ikaw na mag-drive. Oh. Pero maya-maya, ayoko. Gusto ko ako mag-drive. Why? Because when I'm driving, I'm active. And you know, when I'm driving, I'm praying. And the more I pray, the more na nagagaanan yung loob ko, naliliwanagan ako. You know, yun yung sinabi ng day that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Okay? Consider him that endures as contradiction of sinner against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your mind. Amen? So that is the first advice or first instruction of the Bible, how we could deal with stress. Amen? You have to refocus your mind on Christ. By refocusing your mind on Christ, what do we see? Number one, he is sovereign, in control. He is the shepherd. He will guide you so you don't need to be confused along the way. He is our source. Hindi man mawala yung struggle, pero bibigyan ka ng kalakasan. And he is our standard. Okay? Now, number two, the second instruction of the Bible, we go to letter E. How do we deal with stress, mga kapatid? Is this, establish, the word is establish. Ibig sabihin, don't wait for this thing to happen. Nobody will do this for you. You have to do it yourself. You establish an organized life of stewardship. Establish an organized life of stewardship. Now, remember that you are a steward. When things become problematic, sometimes it's not the fault of people around you. It's simply because of your lack of management. Many of our problems, mga kapatid, is lack of management. We could have avoided unnecessary problems if we had to manage earlier or ahead of time. So tinuturuan tayo ng Biblia sa concept ng stewardship na kailangang mag-establish tayo ng maayos na pamumuhay. Now, during the seminar last week sa conference, ang binigay sa akin na topic is time management. Now, I tried to research and my study help me realize that you cannot manage time because time is just flowing. What you can manage is what you do on that given chance. Yung panahon na yon, anong pwede mong gawin? Halimbawa, nasa church ka. You cannot manage the time because the time will just pass. Dadaan at dadaan lang yan. What you can do is to manage what you can do with that given chance. Now, while you are in church, you are supposed to worship God. Now, did you really worship God? While you are in church, you are supposed to be recharged by the Word of God. Are you being recharged? So if you are not being recharged, there's a problem. Hindi ko kasalanan pag umuwi ka na hindi recharged. Hindi ko kasalanan pag umuwi ka na hindi napanakas. Amen? I know that many of you have kids right there, but even when you are taking care of your kids, you have to make sure you're listening. Hindi po pwede yung, nanghihina ako, galing ako sa church, pagod ako kasi nag-alaga ako ng bata. Napagod ka man physically, pero dapat na-recharge ka pa rin spiritually. You need to be listening. That's why, you know, I was telling last Saturday night during the meeting, kayong mga nasa AV, kahit nasa AV kayo, dapat hindi lang kayo nakatutok sa ginagawa nyo, nakikinig din kayo ng preaching. Kasi maya-maya, kayo yung mga active sa AV, kayo na yung magiging backslider kasi hindi na kayo nafe-feed eh. Naunawaan ninyo? So while you are busy with the technical, you know, things in the church, you need to be listening because that's a given time. You're supposed to be recharged. Naunawaan nyo? So if you don't manage, that's how to deal with stress, mga kapatid. Now, Pastor, saan po yan sa Bible? Okay, dumako tayo sa Genesis. Genesis chapter 1. Let me end here. Dito muna ako magtatapos, ha? Genesis chapter 1, verse number 2. Okay? Biruin mo yung isipin muna. Ang dami kong trabaho. Teka, isulat mo muna. Sa totoo, marami ka pang free time pag sinulat mo yung mga gagawin mo, eh. Genesis chapter 1, verse number 2. Irugida di verse number 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Now, Bible scientists and Bible scholars said there was something that happened between verse 1 and verse 2. Because in verse 1, we see God creating the heaven and the earth. Verse number 2. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Now, this is just like this. You went to buy a house. Okay? Everything is damaged. Water system, piping, aircon is damaged. Everything is makaalat. Agtudtud. What do you do with the house? Do you just go ahead and stay? You'll find it difficult. You can have a house but not a home. Kasi pag hindi mo inayos yung bahay, kahit may bahay ka, parang wala kang bahay. Baka mas masarap pa nga ang tulog nung natulog na lang doon sa may bandang corner ng mall. Diba? Kasi maayos yung paligid niya. Natulog na lang doon, sarap ng tulog niya. Pero ikaw, ang ganda na, laki ng bahay mo, pero ang gulo. You will not have rest. So what do you do with the house? You fix it. You organize things so that you can properly function inside the house. Do you understand? The same thing what God did. Kaya sabi ng Bible, the earth was without form and void and darkness. That sounds like depression to me. That sounds like negative to me. That sounds like, you know, stressed out. Without form and void and darkness was upon the face of the deep and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. Now, what is the next verse? Look at verse 3. And God said, let there be light. If you look at it from that day after another day and another day, for 6 days, God did not create the world. God organized the world. And in organizing, he had to create some things. Because when God created the world, it's in verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The day of creation is not 6 days. The day of creation is only 1 day. The following days, God organized the earth. Para ang tao makapag-function ng maayos. Tignan mo yan. You try to live every day unorganized. How could you? Diba? I mean, can you work on a space when everything is not organized? I mean, table, for example. Can you work on a table where, man, everything is makalat? You simply cannot. Are you with me? Kaya, you know how we should deal with this stress? You need to establish an organized life. You need to manage. You need to have time management. You need to have money management. You need to get your finances organized. I know all of us are struggling with finances. Listen to me. Our struggle with finances is not the limited finances. Binigay ng Panginoon yan, hindi pwedeng kulang. God gave that to you. Hindi pwedeng kulang. Kailangan lang natin i-manage yung binigay ng Diyos. Ngayon, kung minanage mo, medyo kulang pa rin, that's when you have to ask God and say, Lord, kulang. We ask that you provide. And He will supply. Bakit hindi? Naunawaan po ninyo? So let's go home tonight. Una sa lahat, okay, refocus your mind on Christ. Foundation mo na yon. Okay? Then, in the practical aspect, gayahin mo yung ginawa ng ating Panginoong Diyos. He created the earth, and then the next thing He did, He organized the world. Inayos niya, sabi niya eh, dapat yung lupa at saka yung tubig maghiwalay eh. May pinaghalo ba naman? Nung verse 2, everything was without form and void. Naghalo yung tubig at saka lupa. Eh, paano ka mag-function dyan? Diba? So, ano ginawa ng Diyos? Maghiwalay. Pati nga yung ano eh, pati nga yung atmosphere, yung tubig sa taas at tubig sa baba, pinaghiwalay na rin yun eh. That's what you call sorting out. So you have to differentiate what is urgent, what is important. God is a God of order. And if God is the one in control of your life, you will order your life. You will set your life in order. That's how we deal with stress. Diba? Family ng, yung time natin sa family, time sa mga anak, you know, everything. It can be organized. Amen po ba? I hope I left something wonderful to you this afternoon. Lord, thank you so much at purihin ang inyong pangalan. We give you glory, honor, and praise. And I pray that you help us deal with stress. And sometimes we are only dealing with the symptoms of stress. Yung mga sakit namin, yun na yung bunga ng stress namin. Taas ang dugo, taas ang sugar, kung ano-anong sakit na meron na kami. And we go to the doctor and the doctor help us deal with this sickness. We fail to realize we are only dealing with the result of stress. Now, we need to deal with the cause of stress. It is our lack of management. It is because we do not pray, we do not look upon Jesus. Salamat Panginoon na sa hapon na ito, you help us dealt with the reason and cause of our stress. Pag na-deal namin ang cause of stress, we would not have to deal with any symptom and effect and result of stress any longer. Salamat Panginoon, in Jesus' name, amen and amen.